I am Laszlo Fraser. Upconversion is a way to spontaneously increase the energy of light. The law of conservation of energy says that energy cannot be created or destroyed. We are going to see, using energy level diagrams, how upconversion increases the energy of light while obeying the law of conservation of energy. The reason we want to study upconversion is that it can improve the efficiency of solar cells. The most important property of a solar cell is the band gap. The band gap determines what light is captured by the solar cell and what light is transmitted, passing through the solar cell and getting lost on the other side. The larger the band gap of the solar cell, shown on the horizontal axis, the more light that is transmitted, since shown in blue. The light that's converted to power is shown in black. We want to make that as big as possible. If the band gap is too large, too much light is lost because it passes through the solar cell and the amount of power produced is reduced. Light that is captured by a solar cell is converted into kinetic energy in an electron. So energy goes from light to energy in an electron. The electron loses some of that energy as heat. This is called relaxation. The amount of relaxation depends on the band gap. If the band gap is large, there will not be very much relaxation. If the band gap is very small, then most of the energy that is in the electron will be converted to heat instead of electricity. Solar cells cannot make use of heat. So, when designing a solar cell, the band gap should be selected so it's not too large, transmitting too much light, and not too small, releasing too much energy as heat through the relaxation process. We want to use upconversion to take the transmitted light and convert it into higher energy light, which can be used by the solar cell. This will get rid of this huge area of losses, increasing the efficiency of solar cells. Now, converting light to a lower energy is perfectly normal. Ordinary materials can absorb light, release some heat, and then release the remaining energy as light again. Upconversion materials, like in this example, take low energy light and convert it to higher energy light. So here, red light has been turned into yellow light. Yellow light has more energy than red light. We need to see how this can happen in this experiment while obeying the law of conservation of energy. Upconversion is made up of two kinds of molecules, a sensitizer and an emitter. These molecules have three different states that we care about. The first one is the ground state. This is the lowest energy state and the one that molecules normally have. The ground state is able to absorb sunlight. There are two kinds of excited states that can be present after some energy has been added from sunlight being absorbed. Triplet state stores energy. The singlet state takes energy and releases it as light. The reason for the names triplet and singlet is that there are three triplet states and one singlet state. For our purposes, the three triplet states are all the same. The sensitizer and emitter molecules make up the upconversion material. There's many of each kind of molecule in the material. The first step of upconversion is for the sensitizer molecule, which starts out in the ground state, to absorb light, which changes it to the singlet state. The singlet state in the sensitizer is then converted into a triplet state. Sensitizer molecules need to be selected to efficiently change singlet states into triplet states, which will store energy. This prevents the singlet state from emitting light. Next, the triplet state needs to be transferred from the sensitizer molecule to an emitter molecule, like this. This happens when a sensitizer molecule in a triplet state comes close to an emitter molecule in a ground state. The mechanism is that electrons are exchanged between the sensitizer molecule and the emitter molecule, which allows the energy from the triplet state to move. So these processes need to happen many times in parallel. So in some other molecule, the sensitizer ground state absorbs light, becoming a singlet excited state, and that singlet excited state is converted into a triplet excited state. Then the triplet excited state moves from the sensitizer to the emitter. Once many emitter molecules have got triplet excited states in them, they can begin to annihilate. This happens when two triplet excited states are close together. They will destroy each other. What happens is, in one molecule, the triplet is changed to a ground state. The other molecule takes that energy, adds it to its own energy, and goes from a triplet excited state to a singlet excited state. Finally, the singlet excited state of the emitter molecule emits light, bringing all our molecules now into the ground state, back where we started. So we've taken some low energy light and converted it to high energy light, which is what we want to do. Every step of this process loses a little bit of energy as heat. So when the sensitizer goes from the singlet excited state to the triplet excited state, this much energy is lost. When the triplet energy is transferred from the sensitizer to the emitter, a little bit of energy is lost. During the annihilation process, we start out with the energy of two triplet states and finish with the energy of one singlet state. We select the emitter molecule so that the singlet excited state has a little bit less than twice the energy of the triplet excited state. So you can take this energy from this molecule, add it to the energy of this molecule, and we get a little bit of loss. Every step in the upconversion process loses energy. Every step obeys the law of conservation of energy. To understand how we get a spontaneous increase in the energy of light, it's crucial to view the light as particles or photons. The particles you start out with have less energy than the particles you finish with, but the number of particles is reduced by at least a factor of 2. So there's an energy increase multiplied by a decrease in the number of particles, then the total energy of the system has not increased. However, the amount of energy that can be used by a solar cell has been increased. This will make our solar energy systems more effective, making it easier for people to get access to the energy they need. So, there are some challenges for making upconversion a useful technique. There are two scientific challenges. The first one is improving the energy storage. We want triplet excited states to store energy and not get lost. Second one is improving annihilation. When two triplet excited states get close together, we want them to destroy each other. So we want to increase the rate of annihilation for two triplet excited states that are close together. When the annihilation occurs, we want to ensure that it results in a singlet excited state and not some other state that might be present in the molecule. There are two engineering challenges. First one is to improve the way that sunlight is captured. The sun emits different colors of light. Those colors are some you can see and some you can't. The amount of each color is not the same. Instead, it has some distribution. That light passes through the Earth's atmosphere, where some of the colors are removed, especially ones you can't see. What we want to do is make a sensitizer that absorbs light very strongly in the colors that are present after the light has passed through the solar cell. So that's a matter of tuning the absorption of the sensitizer to match the light that's available in the system that you want to use. Another crucial factor is durability. Solar cells are typically left installed in the field for decades. We need to make upconversion devices that last for decades. We know that if oxygen is in the device, it will capture and destroy the triplets, which is undesirable. So it's important to engineer containers which keep oxygen out of the device for a long time. Once that's done, we need to investigate how long the device lasts, because at present, nobody knows. So, in conclusion, upconversion is a way to take the light that passes through a solar cell, convert it to a higher energy, and then use that to make electrical power that's useful. This process obeys the law of conservation of energy, because while the energy of the photons that make up the light has increased, the number of photons has decreased, ensuring the total energy of the system decreases through the course of the process. Thank you.